thank you for allowing me to come and be part of this. I mean, I'm so excited. I came here in 1962, and there was less than 1,000 engineering students here then. And I don't think there was more than 10 faculty, who knows? But there weren't very many people then. You are so privileged to be here with such great faculty and great facility. I think we have 26 buildings now and 1 million square feet of research and teaching facility. I mean, my gosh, how fortunate are you to be able to be in that kind of an environment? And I and our family are so happy to be able to further that in some way. The education I got at the University of Florida, the discipline that I got at the University of Florida was so extraordinary. And it really is the thing that really kind of changed my life.
What does innovation mean to you?
Innovation means imagination. I think to be a great engineer, you got to have imagination. Because you're seeing things that no one else has ever seen before. You're improving something that someone else has not improved before. You're thinking out of the box. No one has an education like engineers. We are so unique. We have the opportunity to be able to do things that others can't even imagine because of our education.
What's like the greatest life advice that you can give me and others to create a successful company?
Get up in the morning early and go to bed late and hang around people who are interesting, creative, and fun. Fun is probably the most important thing you should seek in your life. Enjoy every day of your life. If you don't enjoy it, you should be doing something else. Because your time is the only thing that's not replaceable. Find something that really interests you. And don't doubt yourself. You're special. You're engineers. Not everyone can be an engineer. It's tough to be an engineer. But what we got at the end, and there's never really any end, is the ability to do things and see things that no one else is able to do. Big changes are difficult to do, but if you've been taught a particular way of doing something, vary it by a little bit and see if that is successful. Vary it by a little bit more. And pretty soon you say, well, I've made a reasonably big change, little by little by little. And if you do something that's a little bit and it's not working out, it's easy to back up and then go in a different direction. You know when it's right or when it's wrong, and if you don't know when it's right or it's wrong, it'll eventually come to you. You might have to step back 5 steps rather than 3 steps, but just do it. If I only had to pick one word that would describe my life, I would take the word discovery. That's who I am. Is my joy in life is through discovery. The status quo never exists in my life. It's not part of my vocabulary because I'm a stochastic person. It's never static. It's always dynamic. You see a need, you think about it, and you maybe tuck it away, but at least you're thinking about it because it's in your subconscious or maybe in your dreams. And then you say the next morning, yay, look, I figured this one out, or maybe there's a problem here.
What is it that made you choose to be so charitable when it's sometimes a little bit easier to spend all of your time and money and resources on just yourself and your family?
Do something nice for someone if you can, as often as you can. It's not just monetary. It's when I said do something every day that you wouldn't normally do that benefits maybe yourself, but other people. Just try it every day. And if you didn't get it done that day, then do twice the next day. It's one of these things that you can actually take care of the residual. I think of all of you students and the faculty as my ambassadors. You are my legacy. You are going to go out there and do good like I'm not possible able to do, but on the level that we're going to be able to train thousands and thousands of engineers every year, and they're going to go out and do good things for our society and our humanity. That's my legacy. We want to be able to have people like yourselves go out and do good. You are our instruments of our heritage. So I thank all of you for coming and being part of the School of Engineering and allowing me to answer your questions today. Can we get a photograph of me with my emissaries here, my ambassadors?